Hey everyone, Bashu here. This isn't going to be any gameplay footage. It's not going to be highlights from the stream like we normally see here on the channel. This is going to be something a little bit bigger. For those of you that don't know, June is National Oceans Month, with June 8th being World Oceans Day. In honor of that, throughout the entire month of June, all proceeds from the stream, every sub, every bit, every donation, all the ad revenue, everything is going to be going to the Coral Reef Alliance. The theme of my channel is based around this beautiful saltwater tank here next to me that you guys can see every time I stream. And because of my passion for the ocean, coral reefs, saltwater fish, corals, all of that, I wanted to give back. I want to do something different. I want to do something important. And I would love for you guys to help me along the way. I stream almost every night on twitch.tv/Vashumat. Link is in the description below. Please stop by, check it out, do what you can. Even if you can't give anything, that's fine. Just having a viewer in there to bump our stream up the list so more people can see it, come in, see what the cause is all about. I would greatly appreciate it, truly. Throughout this video, we're going to be talking about Coral Reef Alliance, what they're doing to save the coral reefs, what the coral reefs are facing, and how we as a collective group can come together and help fix the problem that these coral reefs are facing. Please give the video a like. Subscribe if you want to see more content on this. Watch it all the way through. It really means a lot and it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. Also, if you don't mind, share this to as many people as possible. Throw it up on your Facebook, your Twitter, all the social media. Get the word out there. The more people that we can get this message to, the bigger turnout we'll have. And I'm really hoping for an absolutely amazing event. Every Saturday throughout the month of June as well, we'll be doing a special charity stream from 5 p.m. to midnight Eastern Standard Time. We'll be playing with viewers. We're going to have other streamers on here. We're going to be working together to raise awareness to this cause. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoy it. 70% of our planet's surface is ocean, and coral reefs make up 1% of the ocean floor, but 25% of ocean life relies on coral reefs all over the world. 500 million people depend on coral reefs for food, income, and coastal protection. While climate change threatens their future, science shows that corals can adapt and survive if we keep them healthy. The absolute legends at Coral Reef Alliance work at the local, regional, and global levels to keep coral reefs healthy. The work that they do will allow corals and coral reefs to adapt to climate change and survive for generations to come. As one of the largest global NGOs focused exclusively on protecting coral reefs, the Coral Reef Alliance has used cutting-edge science and community engagement for nearly 30 years to reduce direct threats to reefs and to promote scalable and effective solutions for their protection. They cannot do this alone, and without the help of thousands of people all over the world and people like you and me doing everything we can to make a difference. On October 5th, 2021, the Global Reef Monitoring Network released its latest international report. This details the status, trends, and predicted futures of our world's coral reefs. After analyzing almost 2 million observations collected in 73 countries, one key message is abundantly clear. Coral reefs are in trouble. We've lost 14% of the world's coral reefs in the last decade, according to Dr. Madhavi Kohl. This is likely a conservative measurement. She's quoted saying, "It's the equivalent of losing the entire Great Barrier Reef in 10 years. And sadly, findings continue to show that reefs are continuing to suffer and diminish. Due to climate change, ocean temperatures are rising, and these trigger bleaching and ultimately impact the coral reef's health. Coral bleaching happens when the temperatures become too warm, causing corals to expel their symbiotic algae that live inside them, causing them to turn white and lose an important food source. This leaves the corals more vulnerable to disease and will eventually die. Some scientists predict that 90% of global reefs will experience severe bleaching annually by 2055. One of the solutions of the past relied on coral restoration. These projects help to propagate corals and outplant them into the wild. Unfortunately, this approach was not successful at preventing a decline in coral coverage in the next several hundred years due to climate change. Selective breeding of corals to be more heat resistant will only lead to benefits if conducted at a very large and expensive scale over the course of centuries. Even then, the benefits won't be realized for 200 years. While coral restoration can have some benefits, this alone is unlikely to save coral reefs from warming waters. The goal now of many organizations, including that of Coral Reef Alliance, is reducing marine threats and advocating for climate change. Our coral reefs have the best chance of surviving climate change by implementing effective reef management strategies that focus on protecting the natural genetic diversity. By doing so, these coral reefs will be able to adapt to climate change on their own. In Hawaii and the Mesoamerican region, the Coral Reef Alliance addresses overfishing, protecting marine habitats, investing in wastewater treatment infrastructure, mobilizing communities to save their coral reefs, and more. On a global scale, they advance innovative technologies like the Alien Coral Atlas to help stakeholders better understand how to factor natural evolutionary processes into their conservation efforts. By reducing major threats like overfishing and water pollution, we are keeping coral reefs healthy at the local level, says Dr. Helen Fox. We are also advocating for climate action and building worldwide partnerships and spreading awareness of how to create the necessary conditions for corals to adapt to climate change. Coral reefs are some of the most threatened ecosystems on the planet. Currently, 75% of the world's coral reefs are threatened. 90% of coral reefs will be threatened by 2030, and all of them will be threatened by 2050 if we don't take action now. By keeping them healthy and reducing local threats and curb our carbon dioxide emissions to slow the pace of climate change so that our coral reefs can adapt to rising temperatures all over the planet. Coral reefs are an integral part of our ecosystem and our planet. Again, please join me throughout the month of June to help make a difference. Together, we can actually change this and ensure that these reefs and all the life forms around it will be around for generations to come. I encourage you again to share this video with as many people as you know on as many platforms that you have access to. This is a cause that all of us need to come together for, and it's something that I am extremely passionate about. Stick around to the end of the video to meet the team of Coral Reef Alliance and see the faces of the absolutely wonderful people who fight every single day for our coral reefs all over the planet. Again, every Saturday we'll have a special stream to raise money for these absolutely wonderful people. Thank you for watching. And if you need a reminder of how important these are, this is what we'll lose if we don't change this now.